Alrighty, Operation Steely Shadow.
Let's go take a supply raid.
Sky Ranger deployed.
In position. We'll be using almost exactly the same tactics as the last mission, but I'm going to be a bit more careful and make sure I don't get caught out in the stealth phase. And yeah, try to use those battle scanners to our advantage.
Recon indicates an advent train was recently disabled in this area by the Resistance. And so far the aliens haven't managed to move it out of the region. We're heading in to seize any assets and technology we find. Neutralize all hostile contacts and secure the AO.
Good thing, Central. Bum bum. Gotta love this game, man. The music is so good. Well, everything is so good. Yeah, interesting location. Lots of high cover. Lots of hard high cover as well with those. Ooh, that mech archer. Oh god, that is so scary. So mech archers launch grenades without a range restriction. So I kind of feel like we should explore this part of the map and see if we can't put one of our snipers in a position where they can see that mech archer. That mech archer is public enemy number one. Muton Pyro, interesting. It's called a keep. You know what, just make sure there's nothing. Oh, actually, that's great. We can put one sniper up on the high ground here. That's the end of the map, almost. Just make sure there's nothing up there. Looks like there isn't. Now, try to remember, who did I give the blue screen rounds to? Which of the two snipers? I think it's Truth, because we're getting plus one damage here from dragon rounds. Yes, definitely. Okay, so it's the Truth who has green. I'm going to put her right behind this little bit of half cover here. She should have vision on the mech archer from the above. Run.
Yukuzo.
Because yeah, I also have hardly stopped playing this game since it came out. I don't actually like this position too much for Frozen Isle. I'm not going to have the best vision. I mean, this is going to be a problem. Aliens are going to sit there and there. I wonder if we can take this building. Probably going to be too risky. Let's just move forward here. Fight them here. Yeah, we'll use our shinobi and our assault to take anything that goes there. We've also got good grenades. And it looks like there's that little bit of rock there, which is explodable. So if a unit stands there, we can explode that cover and at least get one round of being able to shoot at it. Amps, you know what? Just stay there.
Will do, sir.
Gotta bear in mind that Shadow King, first of all, I've got to change his voice back. He's got, as much as I love this African voice back, it doesn't suit a French Canadian.
Copy that.
Yeah, Mikey's got this African accent because he is actually South African. Mikey's my friend I went to high school with. Governator, move forward.
It's a good idea.
Yeah.
Pashol!
Big pancakes is a Russian.
Very cool.
Denson, I want you to take that spot. This is not. Can't reach it just yet.
Big leaps for a while now.
You hear that? That's the sound of the Berserker Queen. Okay, that changes things substantially. That means we want to be sitting in the corner. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to put our one sniper here. We'll leave James where he is there so he can shoot at a different angle. And then we'll take, yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4 bits of high cover. So whatever comes here, that'll be explodable. That'll be explodable. That and that won't be. But at least anything that takes cover there to shoot at us here will be flanked by Jawara. Okay. Well, we could be in for a fairly rough mission.
Aye, aye, Commander.
Remember, as soon as we get detected, that Berserker Queen is going to start moving towards us. If this was a mission where we didn't have stealth, as soon as you move anyone, the Berserker Queen starts moving towards you. Which you can actually use to your advantage. Because you know it's coming, so set overwatch traps for it. And it usually hits you before very many of the other aliens do. Oils always peeled for the brawn. We've frozen our back now. He's grand there. He's fine. Pancakes, though. The Grenadier.
Выхожу.
Things are going to get very, very hairy, friends. I guarantee you that. Berserker Queen is going to be interesting. But we have...
Alien scumbag!
Ooh, shit, hello. That's the mech archer and it's moved. Okay, so we are only going to engage in these guys once we have vision of the mech archer and we can hopefully one-shot it with our sniper. Auto dock, which is irritating, but it's not the end of the world. Oh, don't come towards us and reveal. Yeah, it looks like they're going to keep moving this way, so we'll just hang tight for a turn or two. That is tempting. Well, it's good to know it's there. Need to take that shot.
Trust me.
I just need to wait another turn for these guys to move. I know you can throw a battle scanner while remaining stealth, but being under vision there, I don't even want to take that chance. Third, okay. The Grenadier cheats. There's a lot of really, really nasty aliens out here. That mech archer worries me the most, like it'll shoot grenades here and remove all of their high cover. So I'm just going to wait for these two to move, and I'm going to move these two forward, hopefully get vision of that pod, and they'll open up on the mech archer, and then we should be fine. As long as we can keep our high cover intact, we should be fine. Big if though. Good, they're moving away as I'd hoped. Still don't think I can move Skulder and I can if I... Oh, you see how the Shinobi has a smaller detection radius than other troops. Very interesting. Don't want to take any chances here though. Okay, what can you see? Any tactics, Grenadier? Still no mech though. So you might think you can put your Snobby here. But if one of these aliens is there, it'll have vision around that corner as well, which will be a reveal, but that shouldn't.
Affirmative!
Shouldn't. Whew, scary. In fact, I want to move some resources to the left flank.
I have my orders!
I can barely articulate how important it is that we kill that longbow as soon as we can. They are absolutely lethal. You know what? Dead King. Oh yes, I remember that he has EMP. I'm gonna move him across.
Affirmative.
But once we fight that mech, I can use him if I have to. Honestly, I'm more concerned about that longbow mech than I am about the bloody Berserker Queen. Now, I know this is a bit slow going and maybe not the most entertaining viewing, but if we get this wrong, we'll be in deep doo-doo. Skelder, take that battle scanner for us. Hopefully give us a visual. It does, but it's unlikely we're going to have an angle that we can make use of. Big question is, what can the truth see? Truth can't see shit. And that mech doesn't look like it's moving. What we do is, we can see him and we can shoot on the next turn. That'll be the better spot, I think, if that mech doesn't move. What? They lied to us. It said it had vision from there. Yes, it's got vision. Let's try from here then. Doesn't look like that worked either. Yeah, we're gonna have to wait for that pod to move a little bit.
I got it from here. Ясно, буду на чеку.
At least we know that Skulder can come across here without getting rumbled. Okay. If things go super badly, then our assault trooper can move up here, shoot at Mech Archer. His blue screen rounds. God, there's a lot of aliens we need to kill here so quickly. Anything with explosives is absolutely lethal.
Affirmative. Eyes peeled for the prawn.
Oh, move, you big bugger, come on. Seriously? Oh, I don't have a visual there. Hoping I can see. That hasn't moved, so we just wait one more turn.
I have my orders.
We know that Longbow Mech Pod will move. That was there when we first saw it. It moved there, so it'll move at some point. Patience, friends, patience. Just notice the game volume's a touch, though, isn't it? Something's close. What a bad feeling about this mission. Yeah, this is getting irritating now.
Aye, aye.
I'm trying to get one trooper to get a visual. Got eyes on, and hell, we can even have Shadow King kill it. Got blue screen rounds. It's not going to be the most accurate shot, but the main reason I want that is so that I can have the truth line it up. It's like that. Okay, good. We are finally good to go on the next turn. Thank you all for your patience. Watch the damn thing move now.
Gotcha. Monitor sector.
Skulder. This is going to be great. Sniper shot, reload, or sniper shot, pistol overwatch. You won't need to steady weapon on his third shot because of this advanced reserve mag. And I can't tell you that the superior suppressor does. The superior suppressor is described as plus 25 aim if out of vision or not in vision, which I thought meant only from stealth, but it also applies apparently. And there it moves. Jesus H. It also applies to squad sight. Is that a second mech archer? Oh my giddy aunt. Okay, strap in folks. We're not going anywhere. We now have to line up two shots on the mech archers. On the plus side, Truth will take one down. And Jawara can take the other one down because he can just shoot twice. Even though he's got dragon rounds, he'll be able to shoot twice with those dragon rounds. We just need to work this now so that we have both mech archers in vision. And I think let's move everyone else up forward as well so we can engage these pods hard on one turn and then fall back, pull them into overwatch on the turn after that. Bonnie, you'll be able to skip into that spot. Cause
the Iceman cometh.
Shadow King will be taking that bit of eye cover once we've been spotted. Yeah, shit is gonna go down in a big way. You better believe that. Oz field for the I've never encountered two longbow mechs in the same mission. Honestly, it's pretty scary. Good. We should be able to get that mech archer in vision for James. The second mech archer pod has to move though. Can she see? Oh, she just can't see either of the mechs. That's frustrating. James, you can only see the adept. That's far enough back, moving. And I think that extra square is not going to help. Yeah, so but if this pod keeps on its bearing towards us, then it should go into James's vision. And we've got a nice little ambush developing here. The other option is... Oh, I missed the trick here. I could have freeze-grenaded both of these pods. Okay, let's hope they don't move and see if we can take advantage of that.
But you understand that this could all backfire.
Aye, aye.
Very, very, very nerve-wracking.
Trust me.
Freedom never sleeps!
On you. Wonder if I move to this spot, she can see the other...
Mew!
Other mech. Oh, has that worked? Perfect. I just mustn't move now. And once we're ready to go loud, we will put Michael into advanced sentinel. Take overwatch shots. Okay. Here we go. Oh my god. Jesus, this is a lot of aliens. This is my I'm worried face. Oh, he's right on top of us. Oh my god. Okay friends, this is gonna go tits up on the next turn. Either this pod's gonna flank the Governator and the Governator can't move. Ooh, 58% chance to control, okay. Okay, so I'm going to have to back my assault trooper to take this high cover position, kill that mech archer. This mech archer, at the very least now, will get killed. Probably by Mikey, who's going to advance sentinel. I'm so confident that we're going to get rumbled now, and I'm going to put everyone into overwatch. One other point of interest is Excellency. Command range can reach 1, 2, 3. And he can engage Oscar Mike if he needs to give these guys extra mobility. OMG. Shit is about to get very real. You know what, I'm not even going to steady weapon the truth. I'm just going to overwatch with that. We need a full overwatch to get absolutely everything we can out of it. And this is concealed overwatch. I'll get my trusty abacus out. Start counting aliens. Evac! Never. We are here to murder aliens, and murder aliens is what we're going to do. I'll only evac once I get into a position where I know we're in such a bad spot, we don't have a hope. And it walks the other way. I was so sure it was going to go down. It still might. The muton pod might come forward. And it goes away. Oh my god. What is happening? Okay. So we... Okay. Alright. Here is the play. Cross bomb. The codex. And both of those mech archers. Truth, what can you see? Codex, which is going to be your kill anyway. Just got to make sure we're not in range of any of the other pods. Actually, perfect. And James will get two shots at this adept. Right, team, strap in. Ship is about to go down. We don't get the overwatch, which I wanted. But I think this is actually even better. I just need to make sure that I throw this in a spot where it hits. Fall. Outside chance it's not going to freeze the mech that we know is over there. Just be sure of where that mech is standing. It can't move to that spot, which suggests that it's right in that square. Epic turtle. The other option is to throw an explosive grenade there. But I don't think I'm going to do that. I'm rather just going to freeze. Because if I throw explosive grenade, the codex will teleport. Is that actually a bad thing? Because it's carrying gear, getting forward. Nah, I'm overthinking this. Let's just freeze these bastards. Is this the right choice? Oh, and 4 damage as well. Sweet. Boosted cores doing work. Okay. Here we go. The governator. 6 to 8 damage, 6 to 7, so that implies he has dragon rounds. Skulder is going to actually stay stealthed. If I can keep him in vis, I will definitely do so. Only 75% chance to hit. Can I justify throwing another grenade? I probably can, but no, I back here to hit the 75. James will just take down this adept. Nice, good damage. Ah, and then death from above, so it looks like death from above is not playing nice with the sidearm holster. It's worth remembering, so we're going to have to put the sidearm holster probably onto our ranger, who can then shoot 3 times, thrice if you will, one turn. I'm going to steady weapon, James. And take another accurate shot in the next turn. Go ahead. Please don't miss. 12 solid good damage. Are we going to need to move forward now? Is that going to reveal you? Potentially. If it does reveal, it's not the end of the world. What it will do if it reveals him is aggro the other 2 pods. So I'll move Lorendio here to take that shot. It's almost guaranteed to aggro that pod. I'm thinking that The mech that's over there is probably low enough that I can kill it with a grenade, with a rocket, and this could probably just be a triple kill straight up.
Bringing the plane.
Loot destroyed, I don't care about that. We're in such a tough spot. Oh, awesome, it opens up vision on the other mech. Perfect. That's an unintended consequence that I'm very, very happy to have. Okay, we've only got Benson and Skulder and Lorendu. So, see, now that I don't quite trust that. I'm gonna trust that that's not gonna reveal him.
Roger that.
Hopefully, not shoot with him if I don't have to. Jazzbot. Does it give us a hack target? It does not. I'll throw an axe to kill that bugger. And then Jensen. Can you see the mech from there? You cannot. And from here, but then he's in vision of the heavy turret, so that's no bueno. And Deus Ex will be in this half cover. Yeah, I'm even scared to put Lorendio here. Chasm is having vision. Is it going to aggro that pod? I don't think so, no.
Copy that.
Before I move him here.
I'm heading there now.
Remove Jensen first. Haywire protocol not worth doing, particularly because it would give the aliens vision of that target as if it was one of ours, which would aggro everything else in vision. And Lorendio, finish it off. In retrospect, we potentially didn't need to freeze there. We could have just used an explosive. These mechs would have moved, but yeah, I think that was the right choice. Okay, let's stop counting aliens. I predict we're going to be fighting 12. That's auto dock plus 2. Oh shit! Berserker Queen plus Muton.
Oh my god! She just had to modify a berserker, didn't she?
Codex and a Serpens. It's vital we kill that Codex to stop it from disarming. And that's 8 and counting. Oh, that would have been great if we could hit that.
Mr. Doggett.
I'm gonna try to hack either the auto dock or one of these heavy turrets. The turret would be great just as a meat shield, really, but the auto dock even more so. I don't see how we can get vision of the auto dock though. As much as I want to fall back, the problem with it is it's gonna pull the berserker towards us. How is that an 80% shot? I think I need to engage Oscar Mike here. This Oscar Mike cost an action, it does. Heavy tactics just does lots of damage. Pyro does damage, sets on fire. Serpents is just irritating, it poisons. Iwara, you can only shoot at that turret. Honestly, I can hardly believe is the case. Well,
yeah,
Jensen can't stay in half cover, that's for sure. Yeah, he still can't see very much of anything. So we can either overwatch everyone, use overwatch all, which will obviously overwatch the entire team. The advantage being the alien ruler only gets to move towards us once. But instead, what I'm going to do is I'm going to be active and fight these guys with a bunch of actions. I actually want to pull this Berserker Queen towards us because I want to fight it ASAP. I want to fight it before we get hit by all the other stuff that's on the map. That could be a good shot. Not accurate enough. Lord Skulder. Can have a good flesh here. That's not cover though, so that's no bueno. Oh, the truth can't see anything, it's so bad. I was hoping she could at least see this turret. That's not a flank on the Muton Pyro, but this is. Also a flank on the Serpents. That's not a flank on the Pyro. That is. I actually like that. Okay, that's good. Shield by 3.
Will do.
This is gonna pull the Berserker towards us. Okay, so Mosen says your sharpshooter with the sidearm holster can shoot twice as long as she doesn't kill anything. It's interesting. Let's test that out, shall we? Because it's gonna take at least such a waste shooting at this turret. If I can get the Berserker Queen to stumble into vision of Jawara, I can hopefully shoot twice at it, set it on fire. I almost certainly want to use Skulder to shade that heavy tactics. I doubt this will kill the Pyro, but it is going to damage it severely. 24 gets through. Did I give any ammo type? What ammo type did I give? Don't recall. So, this Muton Pyro won't die. Being an assault, I just assumed he had close combat specialist, which he doesn't have. It's a bad, bad, bad mistake on my part. What I will do though is move Arnie here and suppress the Pyro, so when it runs, he'll get a shot. I think I need to take that shot. But I'm gonna aid my assault trooper, who is gonna be taking some damage from that Muton. Using the shield as well. Oh, I did not expect to see him there! Closer than I thought. Let's test out the theory that we can shoot twice as long as... No, we need to shred armor first. Big bada boom. Now if I move forward I could have hit all three, but moving forward is no good. I don't want to blow up that cover. Interesting to see whether when the Queen reacts now, whether it's going to run at Shadow King or whether it's going to run towards the source of damage. Let's find out. Stay tuned, folks. Johnny. This is scary. You're damn right it's scary. At this point, we're going to focus on the Berserker Queen. We need to damage her enough that she just books it and gets out of here. Just disoriented, not knocked out. Thank goodness for that. And it moves the bloody Berserker Queen out of vision. I think the Berserker Queen is just going to keep on punching over here. Okay, we're going to use a rocket here. Or a grenade. Why is the Muton stunned? Oh, from the explosive. Okay. I don't quite know why. I don't understand biggest booms or boosted cores to give a stun chance. Ryoji says Flax would never be able to do this, but to be fair, Flax hasn't played like 2,000 hours of XCOM altogether. This is just to shred the remaining 2 points of armor on the Berserker Queen. I think the Governor actually has Salvo. Miss. Oof. God. He does have Salvo. Awesome. So, if we go super balls to the wall here, we go for the flesh. The reason being that it's a 75% stun chance. Is it worth doing? What happens if it fails? Shadow King keeps getting punched. Can I grapple Jawara into a spot where he can lay down damage onto that big nasty brute? Oh, I can blue move and then still be able to shoot. It's gonna get a reaction out of the Berserker Queen though. That's a spot where I can see it from. Vision indicator seems to think so. And I'm gonna take that bet. Trust in the vision indicator. Yes! Yes, and that shouldn't make it react because it's a free action. Oh yeah. What is the Deadeye? 87. Not worth the chance. We go for the precision shot. 55% crit. This should do very, very big damage. Yeah, the throw axe also has a stun chance, but I didn't hit it with a throw axe. Fantastic. The fact that it moved towards the damage source is huge. It also lets Ani hit it with auto targeting, which is going to increase the Deadeye from Jawara. The fact that it went... yeah. See, sidearm holster doesn't play nice with death from above. Is this guy in a spot now where Skulder can flesh him and land in cover? Yes, he can. So we go for the flesh. That should be enough to make it leave. Make no mistake, friends, we're in a lot of trouble. Come on, open your city portal. Get out of here. Okay. Stunned and burning. It means we have to keep pounding it. Suppress might be an option, but as soon as you suppress it, it'll just move and trigger the suppress. Is there really any point in shooting at it with the truth? Probably. She can't see anything else. Dead eye is not going to work. Precision shot. This damage should definitely make it want to leave now. Ooh, we don't have enough to kill it on this turn. Come on, off you go, you big fuck. There we go.
Don't let that thing escape. It's trying to open another rift.
The problem is we only have Michael Stahl, who is going to overwatch and get a shot at it as it runs away to do more damage. But I'm going to use the advanced sentinel to take two shots at it. Or maybe, well, what I hope is it'll take one shot at the Berserker Queen, it'll escape, and then the other shot will be for whatever else is out there. But we're in a dire spot here. There are grenadiers on the map. There at least aren't any more mech archers. Misses anyway. Useless. Get out of here. Okay. Let's see how much damage we take. Oof, the Elite Heavy Texas is going to do a lot of damage here. Moved and marked so it doesn't get to shoot. That's great. The auto dock. It's going to shoot because it doesn't have a heal target. Is that a flank? It probably is. Skulder has armor at least. Shredded though. Bastard. This grenadier is a... just overwatch, please. Don't grenade. Thank God. Thank God. Thank God. Yeah, you guys just stay back and overwatch. That's grand. Ah! That's not good.
I sense injuries.
What is going on there?
Grant me revenge!
86% chance to miss.
Then the hell with you.
Arnie's kicking off. Okay, so what can we hack and what are the chances? 58% chance. I don't want to supercharge it. We'll just shut it down. We'll heal someone. And then we'll go for the hack. On the subsequent turn, we can focus fire it to get through some of that armor, but we want to kill the heavy tactics, the grenadier, and the sniper, and maybe move our troops to the right flank away from this turret. Who can I revive? Oh, revive will remove the disorientation on Shadow King. Don't know if that's actually going to matter too much. No, it will actually. Because the disorientation is stopping us from using flesh. Okay, never mind. We just shoot this thing and probably kill it with our blue screen rounds. Eat it! Okay, I forgot to keep track of all the aliens. Okay, we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Forget it, I've totally lost track of where everything is. Gawara, what can you see? What do your elf eyes see? Oh my god. Nothing useful. You can't just keep plugging away at this turret, I suppose, but. No, it's Mikey who has armor piercing rounds and will make short work of it. He doesn't have a spot in high cover that he can get to where he can see it, though, is the problem. Arnie will take Overwatch. Bet. Let's just think about this. 80% chance to get the snake off of Arnie. Arnie then runs and probably gets Overwatch shot by that heavy turret. It's 80% aim because it has height advantage. Yeah, so I'm going to do this just to remove the Overwatch more than anything. Okay, 2 damage gets through, more than I thought. Okay, some pancakes. Mikey, can you get high cover anywhere here? I really want him to shoot at that damn turret. That would have been great, that would have been great. Doesn't have the movement though. Is that going to be a flank? Yes, it is. I don't know what to do, honestly. Okay, so Skulder. Need to flesh this heavy tactics because it puts you into high cover against this grenadier. He's overwatching, but you're going to be sprinting and you've got armor, so I think you'll be fine. Oh no, the grenadier shot. Stun maybe? Stun please? 75% chance? No dice. Shadow King can get a flank Reno here, but it's not going to do much. I kind of want to remove the disorientation on Shadow King so that he can flesh that grenadier. Or run a gun and shoot it. Day 6. And some pancakes will remove the snake. Is from where? Near these spots already where you can see the snake is just fine. Just don't miss. 65% chance. Low cover showing. Will the flashbang remove the snake? I don't know. Can't take that chance. Okay, so first of all we'll revive Shadow King to take the disorient off of him. See what's the negative status effect here. It's red fog, okay. 45 aim, 6 to 8. Oof. It could one shot if it crits. If I blue move and shoot at the heavy turret, it will be killed. And then we leave Arnie getting strangled for one more turn. That's also an option. Well, I could just lob a grenade. Ah, I've moved away. Okay, this has to work. Okay, Arnie, so what are you gonna shoot at? High cover, flank grenadier. Or high cover, shoot the snake. The snake we know will run because it is flanked. I would put Michael here. I want to put Mike in an Overwatch trap position for that snake. I don't know where I can put him to do so. And he can't reach. Damn it. Mikey's lack of movement here is really, really hurting us. Could put him up here in half cover on Overwatch, but then that heavy turret. Okay, so what is the play here? If we go here and shoot the snake, and then pop out and do something else here the next turn, Shadow King can just guarantee we get the kill on this heavy tactics. Only 80% chance to even hit at all, but it will kill if it hits though. It's a tough choice. I think I have to go for that. I mean, if this thing launches a grenade, there's a couple things overwatching here. They might blue move into a flank, but he's got full 12 hit points and 2 armor, so he'll be grand. Whew, this is scary. Unfortunately, I just don't have an answer for that heavy take. So the heavy tactics only has 45 aims, so there's a pretty damn good chance it'll miss in any event. I'm gonna put Oni here so that he's not in vision of that turret on the next turn. Get wrecked.
Consider that a divorce.
Consider a divorce, yes. The other option is put Mikey out here even in the open. Then if that trooper moves this way at all, killed. Probably. Too ambitious, I think. I'm gonna move Mikey here.
Aye, aye, Commander.
Expect that there's gonna be some troops that come through this alley right here. Unfortunately, I just couldn't do anything about that heavy tactics. I just have to hope that it either misses or doesn't crit. Height boosted though. 8 damage. Jesus,
no,
ouch.
No.
You're gonna panic at least, Hunker. Good. Oh, but. RIP. RIP. Hello. The dodge! Can he survive? No, because the codex just teleports and shoots him in the face. Disarm, thank goodness. And unfortunately, I already used revive, so I can't remove that panic. Please tell me we can see that codex. Only 55% chance though. That would blow up the Muton's armor.
Your mother was a hamster and your father smelt of elderberry.
I'm so glad I made that. Thanks for the follow, Noisel. Your mother was a hamster and your father smelt of elderberries.
Cover me, I'm reloading!
Oh, of course. Have. Wonderful.
Prepositioning.
Sidearm. Oh, damn it. Straight to range. We have a grenade for that turret. Because if I grenade the turret, it'll just fall down. It's pretty clear that I need to flashbang those two. How do we do so? We need to move forward far enough. Damn it! I could. Yes. Oh, God damn it. That heavy tactics really screwed us. go up there, I can. We have an aid protocol available, we do. I could aid protocol Mikey, put him in this bit of half cover here. He'll be able to one-shot the heavy turret with his armor-piercing rounds, and he'll have a shield on him to absorb whatever shot turret takes that does hit him. But I can't do that because I have to heal my assault trooper to try to keep him alive.
Who did this to you?
We're going to heal him, and then we're going to use aid protocol for the defense and the shield. It's the best chance we have of keeping him alive. The other option is smoke, but no. Aid protocol is going to be better. Unfortunately, Arnie can't contribute this round. He just needs to move out of that little AoE. Are you kidding me? You tell me I can't cast aid protocol on my assault trooper. What the fuck? But I can heal him. Really, XCOM? Well, smoke it is then. I think that's the best chance we have of keeping him alive. Is that high cover in the AoE of this circle? I think it is. Oh, damn it! Dodges at least. Yeah, that was sloppy. Take a pistol shot. 28%? No. Damn it, I don't have any answer for that Codex and Muton. The flashbang is my best bet. Well, I can go here and pistol shoot the E-Tactics. What does that buy me, really? In any case, I think Mikey has to go here.
Affirmative.
Kill this bloody heavy turret that's been such a pain in the ass for so long. Of course it survives. One hit point. Down indeed. Okay. So clearly we have to shoot this heavy tactics in his big stupid face. It also moves Skulder back a little bit, and he is. If he misses this, we got problems, but 90%.
A super Earth!
A super Earth! So we can either move forward and plasma grenade, which, you know what, it's going to make the codex split, but there's explosive canister there. We might get another more damage than we think result. Or I can just move forward and flashbang them, which will make the codex aim 55, the mutant will be down to 60, Shadow King will be 20, yeah, he'll have 20 defense from the smoke. So it's effectively 40% chance shot the Muton. I think we're going to take the plasma grenade because we have red fog. Because I think that the damage we're going to do is going to lower the aim of that Muton about as much. No, we can't reach it anyway, so it has to be flashbang.
Граната пошла.
So I can have a 55% chance to damage him and do lower his aim even further, or we can guarantee. I think we have to do the guaranteed damage from exploding the canister. It reduces the amount of supplies we get, but supplies is the least of our concerns here. Did that even do damage to the codex? It did, awesome. Oh, he's bleeding out. I don't have any any medikits left on my specialist. Oh, I do. Awesome. Okay, good. So we're going to go ahead and stabilize. Whew, thank God. He only bled out and didn't die outright. These two are close enough that I'm just going to grenade them. The supplies be damned at this point. Olympic turtle, go there. That should be. Oh no, there will be. I think, yeah, that'll be fine. No, not Rip. Almost Rip. Bleeding out. We got lucky. Wait, where's the muton? I don't want to screw this up. The muton's behind that cover, isn't he? God, this is probably safer. In fact, I can maybe damage the codex without blowing up. Ah, effort. If anything's Rip, it's the supplies. Extra damage.
Watch those supply crates. If you destroy them, there won't be anything left for us to recover once the area is secure.
Hey, 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 Central. Hey. How about you shut the F up, buddy? How about that? We're fighting for our lives here, and you crap on about
supplies.
See
you at the party,
Richter! See you at the party, Richter! Best voice pack in the game.
Locked and loaded. Eyes peeled for the brawn.
Okay, so, yeah. I'm gonna start moving forward on the right flank. Go ahead and stabilize.
This should help with the pain.
I can't revive him, I don't have revive available. But at least we're not gonna lose him. Who else needs healing? The Governator, actually. 6 hit points is in one shot range. And we'll leave our final medkit on our sniper. I've just gotten into the habit of using, of bringing backup medkits on my snipers ever since I failed to do it and then had my specialist go down. And there's no one to stabilize your medic. And I want to see if I can grapple up here because I recall the last two being in this area here. That should do as well, honestly. Jawara has had a very underwhelming performance this mission, but he's just been unlucky that he hasn't had, you know, great sight lines. Neither has the truth, but... Oh, we have a Codex Remnant. Interesting. Why is the turn not ending? Rotation removed. It's probably just going to blink and then do the AoE disarm. Overwatch, fine. Ooh, that's a bit close for comfort. Just give this kill to the Governor straight up, I think. Whew. Holy hell, this was some mission.
Holy God. One of us is in deep trouble.
Yes. He Donald. I'm gonna have Olympic Turtle just creep up here. What? Forgot about that. Okay, so we've got something overwatching there, and we've got something overwatching here. We have Battle of the Overwatchers. I'm pretty confident that Mikey shouldn't get shot when he goes up here. Particularly if he just steps out and then goes straight behind the high cover. He's got armor anyway if he does. Okay, it's the other turret, that's fine. Take a shot at him. Good damage. Ooh, 41% because of the vast distance she has to shoot. I'm just going to keep moving the troops forward.
Yes.
I expect to be able to shoot at whatever else is out there on the next turn. Have a look-see. A Viper Serpents, alright. Not too dangerous. 80 aim, which is pretty dangerous, but it's only got 3 to 5 damage. Man, these turrets have been a pain in the dick this whole mission. And there's death from above. Anyway, everyone else keep creeping gotcha. Forward.
No problem.
The turn isn't ending because we have Shadow King here. We have to manually end the turn. Any Overwatchers? No? Head down, Skulder. Ouchie. Oh, thank goodness for the armor. We're going to have some of our troops out for quite a while. Oh well, what can you do? This should be all she wrote now. And I think I'll let Jawara do the honors here. He hasn't had much to do.
Roger that, sir.
Whew. Let's pick up our wounded and nearly dead and get out of here.
Who's next?
Status confirmed. All hostiles are down.
Tiger power.
Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
Big nasty pointy teeth. I'm very, very, very pleased that Lorindio didn't die there. I expected him to die, to actually bleed out rather than die as a squaddy. It's quite lucky. He would only have will of about 45. So that was a very difficult, and it was the first time we encountered the Berserker Queen, so that's about as tough as it's going to get. At least we, okay, on the plus side, Lorindio didn't die. We shredded all the armor off of the Berserker and we got it down to 60 remaining hit points. No one died. I'm pleased with that. Good God, what's the time? Plus 7. Rally team. Misfortunate soldiers. You can say that again. Take a look at the total shots in Overwatch. 18 active shots, 3 Overwatch shots. No. 100% there, which are not bad, but Michael didn't even take. No, he did take active shots, so that's odd. Okay, so we got to pick an MVP. Yeah, I agree. Given the circumstances, that was a good result. It was a great result. I think MVP has got to go to Shadow King as a squaddy to just man-mode it forward like that. Get taken down and survive when getting shot twice. Getting punched by the Berserker Queen twice and not going unconscious. That's my MVP, so salute to you, Shadow King. Well done. An impressive first showing. Even if it means you get to chill in the med bay, head on the engineers for 40 odd days. Oh, yeah, he's hurt. Only 17 days, good. There's really no choice to make here. It's always close combat specialist. Nobody else get promoted. What the hell? Only 116 supplies, we had to explode some of it, but it's fine. Whew. God, that was hairy. That was hairy. Well, we've got some recruits here ready to go to fill some gaps. But Daniel Shadow King Lorindio, you earned your 2 weeks off, my friend. Enjoy. Oof. That was scary. That was very scary. An engineer. Oh, that's good. Let's finish doing that. Well, this is all taking time away from making contact. But I'm pretty confident that we'll be able to build the Shadow Chamber and do the mission before. So the Avatar project is almost certainly going to trigger. But I'm pretty sure we'll be able to pull it back before it ends the game.
Tactical mission site located.
Very difficult, supplies, counter smart rounds, beautiful. Let's get straight back into it.
For the Western US precinct.
And this is a very difficult, and I expect to fight the Berserker Queen again. So, we're going to take the best of the best. It's a neutralize on VIP to us, so we'll only take out one sharpshooter as opposed to two. We'll take out two grenadiers, or two gunners. Okay, so we only have one assault available, Big Weeps. Base Grenadier, Empana. Best Gunner, Gurgi. Best Ranger, Hunter. Any Shinobis available? Yes. Bron. Best Specialist. I hope we have a Specialist available. I'm concerned they might be stuck in training or wounded. Okay, no. We have Munt and we have Jensen. Let's take Munt out. What are we missing here, friends? Sharpshooter. Gotta be a Mudkip. And as our second class, we'll take out another gunner. We'll take out Francie. Right, I'm knackered. I need a break. So, when we come back, it'll be Operation Night King. Take a note here. We'll be neutralizing an Advent VIP on a PR tour. It's going to be very difficult. We're going to be under a time limit. We're going to be fighting the Berserker Queen. But on this mission, we'll be taking Big Weaves, Brandon Predator Campana, Ryoji. What's the full name? Jumpman, Jumpman. Raheem Fixer Hunter, Marsha the Bron McDonald, Munt, just Munticus. And Boss Mudkip and Francie MLG. Whew, that was hectic. Thanks for watching, everyone.